Source meshes can often have multiple materials. This is common when parts of a mesh have very different materials. For example, human skin versus clothing. Other common examples are trees, which use an opaque material for the trunk and a transparent material for the leaves, or buildings, which have parts made of very different materials, like brick, metal, wood, or glass. Multiple materials are also common when parts of a mesh tile. A mesh with multiple materials will be created or modeled with more than one list of triangles. Each list of triangles is called a submesh. Each submesh can be assigned its own material, and each separate material requires its own draw call, so it's desirable to have as few submeshes as possible. Mesh Baker, with the default settings, will collapse all the submeshes into a single list of triangles. Tiling will be baked into the atlas. This often works well, so it's worth trying this initially to see if it works. However, sometimes there's too much tiling to fit into an atlas, or the materials are too different to be combined. For example, transparent glass and opaque stone. In this case, it's necessary to use the multiple materials feature to create a combined mesh that has multiple materials. This feature works by creating more than one combined material. Each combined material can have several source materials. For example, we can bake several different kinds of trees together, and there will be two combined materials, one for the trunks and one for the leaves. Let's try baking some of these buildings together with multiple materials. The Multiple Materials tool is part of the Texture Baker component. Watch our tutorial on Texture Baker Basics to learn how to create one and add your source objects. Now we can check off the Multiple Combined Materials box, which will bring up this dialog, which we'll use to map all of our source materials to different submeshes. For this first example, we're going to ignore the automatic source to combined mapping that Mesh Baker provides, and instead we're going to do it manually. Clicking the plus button will add a new combined material to our texture bake. Each entry will have a list of source materials, which will be baked into a combined material, which will in turn be a submesh on the combined mesh. I'm going to put all the materials of these two houses onto one combined material. For each material on the house meshes, I can click the plus under Source Materials, find the material in my assets, and drag it into the list. In the end, I should have every material used by the two meshes in the list of source materials. We'll need some empty materials to hold the combined result. The Texture Baker has a handy button that will create them for you. The empty material uses the Legacy Diffuse shader by default. Make sure to switch it to the shader you're using, in my case, URP Lit. Before baking the combined material, I'm going to adjust two settings. I know there are tiling materials in my list, so consider mesh UVs must be checked in order to bake the tiling into the combined material. As a side note, you can find the UV layout of a mesh by right-clicking it and checking its properties using the UV layout view. Even if you're not sure, there's no harm in leaving the Consider Mesh UVs box checked as long as there's more than one material on the submesh. If you're baking at runtime, you may want to double check the UV layout due to the extra time it takes to execute the bake with the box checked. I'll also check Resize Power of 2 Textures in order to avoid wasted space in the atlas. Check the Texture Baker settings tutorial for more information on these settings. Now we can bake the combined material using the button at the bottom of the Texture Baker. It takes around 30 seconds to bake an atlas with this many materials. The result looks good, so we're ready to bake the combined mesh. You can do this using the Bake All Child Mesh Bakers option at the bottom of the Mesh Baker grouper. We appear to have an error. One of the materials in the source meshes wasn't added to the atlas. I'll add it to the list of source materials, rebake the atlas, and then try baking the combined mesh again. The result is a single mesh using one material, which should save 27 draw calls. This is the same thing you would get without using multiple materials, so let's add another submesh so we can make the windows reflective. Back in the Texture Baker, click the plus next to Combined Materials to create another list to add materials to. The list will start filled with the members of the previous list. This can quickly be cleared by setting the length to 0. I'm going to add all the window materials to this submesh so that I can control the reflectiveness of them separate from the rest of the mesh. This is the same process from the first example. Clicking plus, finding the material in the assets folder, and dragging it into the list. Make sure to remove the materials from the previous list so there are no duplicates. This can be done using the minus button on the list with the material to remove highlighted. The previous combined material can be deleted. Creating a new set using the Create Empty Assets for Combined Material button will give us the two empty materials we need. Like before, we'll have to make sure they're set to the proper shader as well. Now just bake the materials again, followed by baking the combined mesh. This result looks the exact same. However, we can now adjust the material settings for the windows by themselves, letting us change the reflectiveness without affecting the rest of the materials. Looking at the main atlas, there are still improvements that can be made. Notice how much tiling has been baked into the atlas for some of the materials. This has caused a major drop in resolution, but we can fix this by moving tiling materials to their own submesh. We also cover this strategy in our dedicated tiling tutorial, which you can watch for more ways to handle tiling. We could do this using the same process as before, moving the tiling material to its own submesh mapping and leaving Consider Mesh UVs unchecked so that Unity's built-in tiling will maintain the resolution. However, this is a good opportunity to look at one of the time-saving tools included with the Texture Baker. Again, let's remove the old combined materials, and this time we'll also remove our source to combined material mappings using the minus button. We're going to use the Texture Baker's automatic source to combined mapping, which requires creating the empty material assets first. Click Build Source to Combined Mapping from Objects to be Combined, and the Texture Baker will automatically create mappings for you. It will separate materials based on shader, and automatically place tiling textures on their own submesh. The console will print a report letting you know which materials were placed where and why. Keep in mind you can still customize the result of an auto-generated mapping. For example, I can eliminate one of the mappings by moving its source material to another mapping and then deleting it. Baking the combined materials will create atlases for any submeshes that have multiple materials, and the rest will hold a single material that can use Unity's built-in tiling. Baking the combined mesh still gives a result that looks identical to the original. However, now the combined mesh is split into multiple submeshes, each with its own material. This won't save as many draw calls as a single material bake. However, it does maintain the ability to customize different parts of the mesh and prevents resolution drops from too much tiling. One last thing to point out is the two settings available on the Combined Materials dialog. Unchecking the first box will stop the auto-generated mapping from putting out-of-bounds tiling UVs onto their own submesh. It will create groups based only on the shader used. Unchecking the second box will allow the mapping to include as many materials as it can into a group, even if it means dropping the resolution in order to fit into the maximum atlas size set in the Texture Baker settings. Mesh Baker is available on the Unity Asset Store. Visit us at digitalopus.ca for more tips and resources for using Mesh Baker.